If you are interested in pursuing a healthcare career, check out this opportunity. MedStars is a summer residential experience at Oregon Health & Science University designed to help high school students learn more about their options in pursuing a healthcare career. This is a highly competitive week-long camp, and only 10 students will be accepted from our region. Applications are due April 5th.
Today in Mr. Cook's office at lunch, there is going to be a meeting about an Asian American Youth Leadership Conference in Portland on May 17th. Anyone of Asian or Pacific Islander descent that loves meeting new kids similar to you and your leadership qualities should check out this opportunity. This is a great way to build up your resume for colleges and scholarships. Now, attention to all faculty. The Community 101 group in leadership has $1,000 in grant money to give out. If you are interested in applying for this grant, please talk to Mrs. Hale or come by the leadership class during fourth period for more information.
In light of the recent national events, Phoenix High School is taking precautions to ensure that we have a safe environment. Officer Bailey would like to address you all on ways we can keep our school and campus safe. Roll it.
Good morning, Pirates. This is Officer Bailey. I want to talk to you a little bit about how you can help us keep you safe at school. I know there's been a lot of concern about school shootings and crises in school, and so I want to empower you with the information you might need to help us to help you. The thing that's most important that you can do is to always keep all the doors and the gates locked. The front door by the main entrance is the only door that you should be able to come in during school hours. If you find any of the other doors unlocked, please let a custodian or one of the staff members know. Also, we put that gate out by the Ag Building so that we didn't have to lock the door connecting the Ag Building to the main building. So please make sure you don't prop that gate open and leave it to where somebody from the outside can come through the parking lot, through that gate, and enter our school. We don't know they're in the building, so please don't put anything in those locks that keep that gate from shutting and locking. So if you do that, both those things, that really helps a lot. Also, if you see somebody you don't know, like another individual, and either adult or kid, coming to the door wanting to be let in, please don't let them in if you don't know who they are. Just wave them over to the front door where they can come into the main entrance and check in at the office. If you see somebody on campus, either in the parking lot or in the building, that you think is suspicious or you think shouldn't be here or doesn't have a visitor's tag, please report that or ask them who they are and ask them to go to the office and check in and get a visitor's pass. When we do our lockdown drills, I need you to take them seriously. This is a really good tool for you to have in case there is a crisis in the building and we need you to be quiet and safe and hide. Now, there are other options, of course, to locking down. If we have some sort of crisis in the building and you have the ability to evacuate, we do want you to evacuate the building. We don't have a designated evacuation point at this time, but we would like everybody to remind their parents if they call them on their cell phone because something, you know, some sort of tragedy is happening in our area or in the school. Please don't have your parent come to the school. They'll just put themselves and others at risk and get in the way of emergency personnel. Have them meet you at that big parking lot across the street from Ray's Food Place on South Pacific Highway. There's plenty of room, people, for all of us to gather down there, for our parents to drive in and pick us up. So don't have them come to the school. Also, if you know of anybody at school who is having thoughts about hurting someone else or is talking about a hit list or bullying, please report that to us so that we can work with that individual to make sure that nobody gets hurt. If they're having those kinds of thoughts, there's no reason to keep quiet. I know there's a lot of kids in other schools where they've had school shootings and other types of violence where they regret not having reported, having heard the kids say that he was making a hit list or that he wanted to hurt somebody. If you know someone is fascinated with guns or making bombs or things like that, that's something that you really can't keep as a secret. Reporting is different than tattling. Reporting is helping yourself and others keep safe. Also, generally, please just be kind to each other. When we're mean to each other and we cause people to feel like they're being bullied or harassed, it only makes them feel bad about themselves and makes them want to reciprocate. So just be kind to each other, take care of each other, and be safe. Thanks.
For all seniors, There is going to be a senior grad meeting in the theater during Advisors on February 4th. In sports news, all the basketball teams traveled to Mazama last Friday. Let's hear how they did.
The games on Friday were big and important games for both teams. The boys' team got a big victory over Mazama, while the girls fell short, with the conference games coming to an end very soon.
We basketball players would like to encourage as many fans to come to the last two home games to support both teams. Haley made a segment to encourage you fans to come out and watch the last two home games of this season, so let's take a look.
Oh my God, Becky, why would you do something so stupid as that? Seriously? No, seriously? Seriously, why would you do something like that? Are you freaking kidding me? Are you kidding me right now?
Come on. I can't, come on!
Pirate.
Hey, have you finished your math homework?
No, I didn't. Did you?
Is there a test today?
Yes, there is a test today. Did you study?
Oh, shoot, I didn't study. That's okay. I'm Asian. I'll pass.
Segment. As the video just showed, to remind you, the last two home games of the season are this Tuesday, the 29th, and senior night on Friday, February 8th. Anyways, it's that time again.
Trivia time. Last week's question was, when was the kids' theater day? And the winner is... Bailey Tony. She said January 21st. You will be winning some services from Sunfire Tanning and Salon.
Sweet. This week's trivia question is, when is the senior night for basketball? Please write your answer along with your name and advisor and turn it into the envelope outside Mr. Rhodes' room. We would like to remind everyone to stick around for the pledge. As always, this has been your school,
your people,
and your news.